Year 6. We're going to have a look in our literacy today at the combinations we were working on before. So that's our combinations of place name and abstract noun. We're going to have a go at extending our original ideas by adding in some more detail. To add in the detail, we're going to look at using some very well chosen, thought out adjectives to add that extra interest to each of these statements. I'm going to start with the city of silence. I'm going to put in an adjective to describe that city. So these are some I've spent some time thinking of different words that I could use. And the one I'm going to choose is the forgotten city of silence. So I can just slot that in there. Forgotten city of silence. Is that why it's so quiet there? Because it's been forgotten about, maybe. I might choose, though, to keep the city of silence and add my adjective in to describe the silence. Very, very quiet sea. The city of frozen silence. So you can put in the adjective before your place or before your abstract noun. Or, like I'm going to, you could be greedy and you could put in an adjective before the place and before the abstract noun. But be very careful, they need to be well chosen adjectives. You don't want to have lots and lots of adjectives. They can clutter up a sentence, it just doesn't sound right. So don't go thinking if I put lots of adjectives in, this will be more interesting. You need to think carefully about what you choose. Right, so the forgotten city of frozen silence. Use that alliteration as well. Now, the station of anxiety. I actually took this combination for somebody's work that they sent in before, and I really thought this was very thought-provoking, the station of anxiety. But I think I carry on with that idea of alliteration. Think about what sort of station it might be. How about a sinister station? The sinister station of anxiety. Anxiety is that worry, isn't it? Something sinister. Be menacing, it could be a little bit dangerous. Sinister station of anxiety. Let me have a think, what could I add to anxiety? How about we have an unknown anxiety? Perhaps we don't know what it is that's causing that anxiety. The sinister station of unknown anxiety. So I used my alliteration earlier on in the sentence. Now, from forgotten cities and sinister stations, I think we need to lift ourselves a little bit. And I've taken this one from Kisra's learning, the well of wishes. So I need to be much more positive on this one. So what sort of well is it going to be? Well, if it's a well that's going to be giving me wishes, it's going to be a pretty wonderful well, I would say. So let's pop that in there. The wonderful well of wishes. Describe the wishes as well, couldn't I? The wonderful well of whispered wishes. It needs to sound that little bit more magical. The wonderful well of whispered wishes. Now, of course, once you've done these, you can play around with them as well. I can swap them over different ways. I could have the unknown station of sinister anxiety. I could take some from here and move them around. Okay, the sinister station of whispered anxiety. So think of your words, think of some really well chosen adjectives, decide where they work the best. On your to-do, you'll have these set out for you to do. Try and do at least three different combinations, make them as interesting as you can. I'm going to leave you with a thought by Kai Corbett now, who wrote that wonderful poem that we looked at yesterday. And this is a thought I want you to look at. When you have finished your learning, you can do it on your to-do or send it through to us at the Year 6 email, whichever you prefer. Remember, every word should earn its place.